Hello everyone, welcome to this session. I am Priyanka Bansode and today we are going to learn about ethical theories. These are the learning outcomes of this video lecture. At the end of this session, students will be able to first explain ethical theories in business ethics and second explain different types of ethical theories related to business ethics. These are the contents of this video lecture. Now, before moving towards to ethical theories, pause the video for few seconds and you have to think and write down what do you mean by ethical and ethical issues. Now pause the video and you have to recall. Ethical concerns not what we do but what we ought. Means what we should to do. It is relating to moral principles or the branch of knowledge dealing with the principles. And ethical issues are occur when a given decision, scenario or you can say activity creates a conflict with the society's moral principles. Now let us see about ethical theories. So already we knew that definition of ethical, then what about theories? So theories means it can be identified as formal statements that explains a certain matter. Therefore, we combine the ethical theories are nothing but formal statements that explains certain matter about what we should to do. When we face with ethical dilemma, or you can say ethical situation in ethics, to examine what problems have arisen with the theories in the past and work toward a better understanding of morality as a whole. But the reason we still search for a consistent theory of morality is because we can't ignore the raw feeling that some things are right and some things are wrong. So, in short, ethical theory is the systematic effort to understand the moral concepts as well as justify moral principles and theories. Some ethical dilemmas or moral problems, such as the question about the morality of abortion, premarital sex, capital punishment, euthanasia, means assisted suicide, and animal rights, and etc. So, in these situations, people have taken the systematic effort to understand the moral concepts and justify moral principles and theories. It provides part of the decision-making foundation for decision-making because these theories represent the viewpoints from which individuals seek guidance as they make decisions. Now, we will see the types of ethical theories. So there are the three types of ethical theories. First one, normative ethical theories. Second, descriptive ethical theories. And third one, contemporary ethical theories. So first type of ethical theories is normative ethical theory. So here norms are nothing but sentences with practical, that is action-oriented input. It is the branch of philosophical ethics that investigates the set of questions that arise when we think about the question, how ought one act, morally speaking, means how should we behave with others morally. So, ethical theories are the rules, principles. With the help of them, we have to determine right and wrong for a given situation. Means it examines standards for the rightness and wrongness of actions. So, for any act, there are three things that might be thought to be morally interesting. So, first one, that is agent. Agent means the person performing the act. Then second, act itself. And the third one is consequences of the act. So consequences of the act means result or importance of the act. Okay. So now we will see the types of normative ethical theories. First type is virtue ethics. Okay. So virtue ethics is nothing but it concentrates on the moral character of the agent. So according to virtue theory, we should too possess certain character, traits, courage, kindly, honorable, compassion, etc. And this should be shown or revealed in our actions. So this focuses on character of the human beings. That is nothing but virtue ethics. Then second type is deontological ethics. So deontological ethics means it concentrates on the act being performed. So according to deontological theories, certain types of the act are intrinsically good or bad, that is good or bad in themselves. And third type is consequentialist. So consequentialist means it holds that we ought always to act in the way that brings about the best consequences. Means people feel very strongly about moral judgments that brings best in all situations. So here it does not matter what those acts are. The end justifies the means. All that matters for ethics is making the world a better place. So these are the types of normative ethical theories. Now we will see second type of ethical theories. So it is a form of empirical research into the attitudes of individuals or groups of people. Because descriptive ethics involves empirical investigation, it is a field that is usually investigated by those working in the fields of evolutionary biology, psychology, sociology, or anthropology. So its aim is what? To uncover people's beliefs about such things as values, which actions are right and wrong. And these things or situations you have to reveal in front of people. And these characteristics of moral agents are good. It also investigates people's ethical ideals also. So, value theory can be either normative or descriptive, but it's usually descriptive. Now we will see the difference between the normative ethical theories and the descriptive ethical theories in short. So normative ethical means it claims our claims about what is right or what is wrong. And descriptive ethical claims are nothing but the claims about what people believe to be right or wrong. Okay, means in both situations we have to decide whether right or wrong. But in normative ethics, this is depending on the claims, what is right or wrong. In descriptive ethical theories, here we have to decide from the people's belief, means whether this is right or wrong. Now we will see example of both. So example of normative is infanticide is wrong. So here it depends on the claims about what is wrong. And example of descriptive is Americans believe that infanticide is wrong. So here it depends on claims about people believes to be wrong, right? So here this is the difference between the normative and the descriptive. Now we will see the third type of ethical theories is contemporary. So contemporary ethical theories and approaches developed mainly in the Western world from early 20th century. These new approaches to ethical thinking, and it has changes in how people think about the societies and their relations with cultural achievements, such as the philosophical thinking. So it has many links with other disciplines in philosophy itself and other sciences. Now we will see types of the contemporary ethical theory, that is nothing but in short about each ethics. So first is ethical relativism. So ethical relativism is nothing but its opinion is that ethics is what a particular society happens to believe what is right and what is wrong. So it is related to society. Then second is postmodern ethics. So it is an approach that locates morality beyond the sphere of rationality in our emotional moral impulse towards others. Then third one is analytical ethics. So here it concentrates on metaethics. It seeks to understand ethical judgments and the character of moral reasoning and search the solution for the problems. Then last one is nothing but it includes the other ethical theories. Okay, so these are the types of contemporary ethical theories. These are the references of this video lecture. Thank you.